Hello everyone! So today we're gonna make a mix with caramel, soft caramel and nuts. And we're gonna put that on a tart case. And it's a specialty in where I come from in France. Tarte grenobloise, we call it, from Grenoble. And let's make it. So, usually the traditional one is only made with walnuts. Because it's the region of walnut tree, but I'm doing a kind of mixed nuts here. So I'm using pecan nuts, 600 gram, John. On the tray we're gonna roast them, 600 hazelnut. And 200 pistachio. Okay, so those little guys, they're gonna go on the oven 140 degrees, so they don't risk any burn, anything, and they rust from the inside to the outside, 140 degrees. Okay, a double check. So they're gonna stay in there for 12 minutes and we'll see, maybe it might be a bit longer. So now our nuts in the oven, we're gonna start to do a caramel. So we need some whipping cream and some sugar. So a kilo of sugar. So obviously this recipe can be divided by four for you because it's quite a big quantity. Come on. Okay. Warming up a pan. Soon start to be hot. We're gonna put a little bit of sugar, and when the sugar starts to melt, it means that it's ready to go. In this pan, we're gonna put 800 of whipping cream to deglaze our caramel. Warming up. Okay. And let's grab a vanilla pod. Little vanilla pod ready for when we have the caramel. Slice in the middle. Scrape the seeds. This one is a tiny one. Okay, so those guys had 12 minutes in the oven and they are nicely roasted. You can taste. No, try a pistachio, it's better. So they have a nice rusty flavor. We're gonna put them here to cool down. So now it starts to melt, so we're gonna put a little bit more. Let it melt again. And once it's all melted, it's gonna start to go very quick. The cream is gonna be boiling in a minute, so we remove it. I'll put it back once we are ready with the caramel. So slow. I wish I could have a stove with gas. Be much quicker. A bit more. A bit more now. Those are big lumps. They will melt. You go much quicker once you have a enough quantity. Slowly but surely, so it doesn't burn. You can control it. If your heat is too strong, it's gonna burn straight away and you won't be able to control it. It goes too fast. Oh, what am I gonna do? Oh, it's too fast. So slowly, gentle, it's nice. Alright, so that is nice and smooth. So we put the last batch of sugar. Let's finish to melt it completely. Gonna put our cream back on the stove. So you need a boiling cream, huh? Okay, so now it has a very nice color. All the sugar is melted. We're gonna put the vanilla pod. And the seeds. And now we're gonna deglaze it with the boiling cream. So a little bit at a time. It's very steamy. A little bit more. If you put too much at once, it's gonna create some lumps. And it'd be very difficult to incorporate the cream into your sugar. Ah, it smells amazing. It smells so good. That's it. And make sure it's well melted. That's it. And now we're gonna sieve it. Sieve it into a bowl. Now it's gonna have to cool down before to use it, before to add the nuts in there. It has to cool down. Voilà. There we go. So this has cooled down now. So we're just gonna, but it's still a little bit warm, but now we're gonna add all our nuts in. And we're gonna mix it through. Let's add a little bit of flaked almond, which I roasted as well. Just a handful. Little bit more, as much as you want, really. But it's nice to have a cut runny mix. So you're sure you'll have lots of toffee to bite in. Voilà, that's it. And with this, we're gonna make little tarts. So I made those tarts before. Sweet pastry filled with almond cream and baked it. I'll put some of that guy on top. So this tart is amazing. So you have the crunch and the softness of the caramel on top, and the base, the sweetness of the almond cream. It works really well together. There we go, beautiful mixed nut tart. Okay guys, so that's all. If you like to subscribe to our channel, we'd be very grateful, and I wish you all the best.